Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we come to you today to ask for your wisdom, your knowledge, and your understanding, and to help us in your ways and your will. And Lord, we are grateful, grateful that you chose us to read your precious word. And it is precious because you place it above your name. And I say all these things, Lord, knowing that it is a precious gift that you're giving me to read your blessed word and to know that you want us to know the truth. You want us to know you. You want us to know our Heavenly Father. And you want us to know the Holy Spirit. And Lord, I'm grateful for that. And I say all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Job 40. Moreover, the Lord answered Job and said, "Shall he that contendeth with the Almighty instruct him? He that reproveth God, let him answer it." Then Job answered the Lord and said, "Behold, I am vile. What shall I answer thee? I will lay my hand upon my mouth. Once I have spoken, but I will not answer, yea, twice, but I will proceed no further." Then answered the Lord unto Job out of the whirlwind, and said, "Gird up thy loins now like a man. I will demand of thee, and declare thou unto me. Will thou also disannul my judgment? Will thou condemn me, that thou mayest be righteous? Hast thou an arm like God? Or canst thou thunder with a voice like him? Deck thyself now with majesty and excellence, and array thyself with glory and beauty. Cast abroad the rage of thy wrath, and behold everyone that is proud, and abase him. Look on everyone that is proud, and bring him low, and tread down the wicked in their place. Hide them in the dust together, and bind their faces in secret. Then will I also confess unto thee that thine own right hand can save thee. Behold now Behemoth, which I made with thee. He eateth grass as an ox. Lo now, his strength is in his loins, and his force is in the navel of his belly. He moveth his tail like a cedar. The sinews of his stones are wrapped together. His bones are as strong pieces of brass. His bones are like bars of iron. He is the chief of the ways of God. He that made him can make his sword to approach unto him. Surely the mountains bring him forth food, where all the beasts of the field play. He lieth under the shady trees, in the covert of the reed and fens. The shady trees cover him with their shadow. The willow of the brook compass him about. Behold, he drinketh up a river and hasteneth not. He trusteth that he can draw up Jordan into his mouth. He taketh it with his eyes. His nose pierceth through snares. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your word as we reflect upon it during the rest of today and think about what you're trying to tell us, Lord. We need you now more desperately than we've ever needed you. And Lord, please guide us and surround us with your grace and your mercy always. We are grateful because we know we don't deserve it, but we need it so desperately. I need you, Lord Jesus, desperately. And I thank you for holding my hand and showing me your word and teaching me what you are trying to say. Lord, I ask that my brothers and sisters worldwide be given extra grace and extra mercy so that they can continue walking on their path towards you. Lord, you are faithful and good, and Lord, I am so grateful for all the mercy and grace you show us on a daily basis. Please strengthen myself and my brothers and sisters worldwide that we can do your work and your will and walk in your ways. And I say all these things in the name of Jesus, my Lord and my Savior. Amen and amen. Thank you for listening. Until next time, God willing, have a wonderful, wonderful day. Thank you. Bye-bye.